target audiences and use titles for your video that are going to connect with that audience. It's also important that the content connects with that audience. So if you have a video that's named Tom Cruise and Mission Impossible 35, and you click in there and you don't talk about Tom Cruise or Mission Impossible for the entire video, people are going to be upset and they're not going to watch any more of your videos. So the content is very important too, and making sure that you're creating content that people can engage with. So my fourth tip would be making content that people can interact with. So YouTube and most social media today, in fact Facebook and Instagram have very much gone this route as well, is very much about the likes and the comments. The more likes and comments and shares your video gets, the more the algorithms are going to push it up and allow more people to see it. They're also, the algorithms are going to figure out what type of people like watching your video. And they're going to push more people in that people group toward your video. So if you can create content that encourages people to interact, do it. Now the simplest way to do it, and every YouTuber in the planet does this, is at the end of the video, just remind people to like, share, and subscribe to your channel. Okay, but there's more. That's generic. That's the bottom line. That's the bare minimum. What you also can do is create, you know, throughout the video, ask the audience questions that have to do with the topic that you are talking about in the video, and tell them that you want to hear their thoughts in the comment section. Now, instead of just creating a video, you're creating something that's interactive, because not only are you talking to the audience, but the audience can talk back to you. And so think about your video in the sense of, what can I do to not only build an audience, but to build a community and encourage that kind of communication? And that's how you create content that encourages people to be interactive with. So those are my four tips for today. They are: know your audience, use titles for your video that are compelling to that audience,
content
that people in that people group are going to care about. Like with her yoga videos, she knows what the people who watch her videos are looking for and what type of yoga poses to do, right? And what kind of videos they want to learn, or what kind of yoga poses they want to learn more about. And then lastly, making sure that you're creating opportunities for your audience to interact with you through the likes and the shares and the comment section. So, well, that's what I have for you today. Any other questions?
No, go ahead.
Well, thank you very much, Jeremy, for such a nice presentation on how to make YouTube videos. And small token.
Thank you.
Special support of your class. So he gave such a clear picture, right? We learn how to set up a background, the lighting, the voice, and voice recording, and video editing. Those are very important for taking good